waiting for the great kickoff.
No sign of nerves here.
And it's a goal.
My word, does victory taste good.
And now a chance for Keegan, and that's it!
Last season, Wolverhampton Wanderers suffered the heartbreak of an FA Cup semi-final defeat, 1-0 to the Arsenal at Villa Park. Newcastle were soundly beaten in the final. Arsene Wenger's all-conquering Gunners completing an historic double. And they're not going to give it up lightly. 2-0 down at Preston in round three, a four-goal blitz guaranteed their fourth round place.
Caballero, maybe. Overmars, maybe. It's four.
Wolves, too, boast a proud FA Cup record. Four-time winners, but none since their black and white post-war heyday. Colin Lee is their latest manager, striving for modern-day success. Heading his crusade is Ireland's answer to Michael Owen, the Irish boy wonder, Robbie Keane, whose goals at Bolton earned them another crack at the holders.
Keane! It's him again! The amazing Robbie Keane!
Molineux is packed to capacity for this Axis-sponsored FA Cup fourth-round tie. Can First Division Wolves maximise home advantage and avenge last season's cup exit against Arsenal? Hello, good afternoon, and welcome to the big match for what promises to be a classic cup tie, played in front of a passionate and vociferous crowd. An exciting 90 minutes to look forward to here, but already today, one FA Cup tie has been completed. At Old Trafford, it finished. Manchester United 2, Liverpool 1. An amazing comeback by United, just 2 minutes from going out. But they're through, hence these scenes of great celebration. Not for young Michael Owen, however, but United win 2-1, their fans elated, Liverpool's totally inconsolable. And don't forget, you'll be able to see the climax of the snooker. That comes later on after this game. Then at 5:45, we'll have live coverage of the fifth round draw from Wembley Stadium. The one to avoid, it seems, is second division Fulham. Kevin Keegan's team struck again yesterday, providing the shock of the round at Villa Park.
Hayward to take. And towards Morgan. It's in! Simon Morgan, one of the Fulham originals, with less than 8 minutes played. It'll be Finnan or Hayward. It's Hayward. It's deflected, and it's two!
A lot of people today gave us a chance here. So that tells me, yeah, we've got a bit of respect. And that's the first thing you've got to earn if you want to be successful. These players are earning respect from people like Gareth Southgate coming up there and Mark Bosnich, who I know, and they come and say, they have to play well, you know, so, yeah, it's good. We're going that way.
And here is an interested Gareth Southgate. Interested is probably the wrong word, but Villa's Gareth is our guest this afternoon alongside Kenny Dalglish. Welcome, gentlemen, to both of you. Tell us about it then, Gareth. Were they deserving, Fulham?
They were. I mean, you know, it hurts a lot to lose a game like that, Bob, but you've got to give a lot of credit to Fulham. They brought the game to us, they played very well, and we couldn't break them down in the end.
Not just Kevin Keegan's influence, is it? They've got some good players.
Well, they have. The whole setup there now is geared to success, and that result will give them a huge springboard to work from.
And you need to pick yourselves up sharply now, don't you?
Well, we do. It's a good test for us. It gives us a kick up the pants. Maybe one or two people getting carried away with this, you know, a little bit of success we've had this year, but we haven't won anything yet, and we've got to make sure we do that.
Wolves, Arsenal, Kenny, how do you see this going?
Well, they went close last year in the semi-final, Wolves, when Arsenal won 1-0. And I think it's going to be a very tight game. I think, as I said, that Arsenal are very strong, very powerful. They got a fright the last round against Preston when they fell two behind, came back, and played really well afterwards. I think really from today, I think if Wolves can stop Mark Overmars, I think they've got a good chance.
And Robbie Keane, do you see him being the main problem for Arsenal?
He's an excellent player, very good finisher. Only a young lad, he's had a problem with his knee earlier on in the season, but he's come back tremendously well from that. And if there is one person that he would like to identify in the Wolves team as being a danger, I think Robbie Keane would have to be it.
Gareth, how do you see it?
Yeah, I think that tussle between him and possibly Matthew Upson will be very interesting. I mean, Martin Keown's a big loss for Arsenal today, but Upson's very highly rated there, and I'm looking forward to seeing him play.
Okay. Well, with less than 10 minutes to kick off, it's a fantastic scene here. Molineux packed to capacity, that's just over 28,000. And for both managers, it's a match of vital importance.
Obviously, they're odds-on favourites to win this game, which you would expect. But, you know, we're going to give it everything we can. We're going to, you know, really go for them, and hopefully we can upset them and try and hang on.
At the moment, I think we have a wide confidence. And we know as well, going there, because all the players now have an experience of English football, they know if they're not up for it and not 100%, we have no chance to go through.
Goal! Goal! Sunday afternoon, and I tell you, it is cold out here, and those fans aren't cold, though. I know that the Wolf is there. You reckon that's Mr. and Mrs. Kenny, don't you?
Well, Gareth was saying, I think he's brought his wife along to keep him out of trouble. He was fighting the last time he was here, I think.
Do you see any... do you really see an upset here, Kenny?
I don't think so. I think Arsenal got a fright, as I said earlier, in the last round. I think they're very strong, and although they lost two goals the last time...
They're still short of three key players, aren't they?
Yeah, but...
Seaman, Keown, Vieira.
But they're no important. It's the ones that are playing that are important. And, I mean, if you look at the team that they've got on the pitch, I mean... Young Upson's come in.
I'll tell them they're not important sometime, Ken.
Well, they're not important to today's game, are they?
Yeah. And Gareth, you tell us about these moments here.
Well, I think Wolves will be very keyed up for it. They're keeping Arsenal waiting there. It's vital for them to get a good start the first 20 minutes of the game. They need to score first, really. I mean, I was at the semi-final last year and Arsenal scored early on and it killed the game, really, and Wolves really need that good start.
Yeah, having said that, Gareth, looking back at that game, in the second half, Wolves did come back at Arsenal quite heavily, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. They seemed to find a bit of belief, and I think the difference today is that they're on their home patch and with this crowd behind them, you know, that might give them the extra yard.
Robbie Keane, who we've already talked about, he only came on in that semi-final for, I think, about, well, the last 5 minutes of the game. But how good do you think he is, Kenny?
Well, he's as good as anybody that will be going about at the moment, give or take the real top ones. He looks a tremendous prospect. I think the other side of the game, it could be quite important, as if Wolves got a couple of free kicks or corners and start throwing it in under the bar, as Preston did against Manninger, and see how he handles that. And if Wolves get their nose in front, then I think it'll make for a better spectacle. But I fancy Arsenal to win the game.
Well, here we are, the players of Arsenal and Wolves just about ready. It's always so tense at this moment in that area just outside the dressing rooms. Why not? So much at stake. So let's enjoy it in the company of our commentary team. The new Nottingham Forest manager, Ron Atkinson, and first, Clive Tilton.
Thank you, Bob. Good afternoon, everybody. We have the setting. Molineux packed to its state-of-the-art rafters. We have the billing. Two clubs whose very mention conjures up images of FA Cup glory days. And we have that twist in the plot which makes for a classic tie. The holders defending their honour against underdog opponents whose fall from the penthouse floor of English football has only served to make them hungrier for days like these. More partisan atmosphere than for last April semi-final, that's for sure. And a different cast list too. Only four of today's Wolverhampton Wanderers lineup started against Arsenal last time. But after all their injury problems of recent years, this is close to a full-strength team. Steve Bull and Adrian Williams, the only notable absentees. Neil Emblem returns from suspension today. And Robbie Keane is partnered for only the second time by the Norwegian World Cup player, Havard Flo. Ron, how are they line up?
Yeah, they'll play with two banks of four. flat back four, four men in midfield, and as you say, keen and forefront. Look for Emblem. Whenever I see Emblem play midfield, particularly at Molineux, he always looks as if he can force an issue and drive from the midfield. A lot of people think he'll play a holding game. I think he'll push on in between the strikers now and again.
Come to Molineux without the spine of their team, really. Seaman and Bold injured, Keown and Vieira suspended. So 19-year-old Matthew Upton breaks into football's most exclusive club, plays alongside Tony Adams in the Arsenal back four, and Remy Gard fills the hole in midfield. Incidentally, they scored the winning goal against Wolves last April. Christopher Ray is in Africa playing for his national team, Liberia. Arsenal just seen quite recently, I think, Ron.
Oh, yeah, very recently, unfortunately. And the guy that's not playing, Keown, I wish he hadn't been playing last week. That's how they'll line up. Almost a variation, slight variation on 4-4-2. Overmars will go back and fill in holes. But, of course, his main strength will be trying to carry the fight down the side. Bergkamp just off the front, one solo striker.
The pitch, which was very wet for Wolves last game here last weekend, is in better shape today. But what price Robbie Keane now? One or two of the executive clubs have expressed more than a passing interest. Goal scoring, only one of his qualities. Wolves have all but conceded that he will be leaving here sooner rather than later. But he has yet to play 90 minutes against Premiership opponents. Came on for the last 5 minutes of last season's semi-final. His manager, Colin Lee, has this week compared Keane to Dennis Bergkamp. Quite a compliment. Last season was full of high spots for him, but not without its frustrations. Remember, Bergkamp missed the FA Cup semi-final against Wolves through suspension and the final due to injury. His cup dreams have not yet been realised. Referee today is Steve Dunn. Arsenal do have a travelling contingent of almost 3,000 inside the stadium. Well, Cyril the Swan was on his best behaviour at Swansea yesterday. Let's hope Wolfie is today. More than just a place in the last 16 at stake, really. The FA Cup's reputation on the line. A competition that never fails to surprise. Ran to form again for the most part yesterday. Mind you, the one result that bucked the trend came just down the road at Villa Park. Can Wolves produce another one here this afternoon? Lee Dixon, who signed for Arsenal 11 years ago to the day. Up towards Nicolas Anelka.
One little problem that Wolves may have, I know we found it last week. Ray Parlour goes in the field an awful lot. Although he says he plays basically as a right-hand player where he is at the moment. He tucks right in sometimes and goes and gets the ball off the back players. A lot of space develops in the space he's left, and that enables Dixon to get down, get into forward runs.
Flick on by Havard Flo, dealt with by Nigel Winterburn. Here's Emblem, finding Robinson, looking for Keane. Tony Adams comes between them. Alert defending by the Arsenal skipper. He's only played four games in the last 3 months because of injury. Nigel Winterburn here, only returned to the team last weekend. Flo third to the ball again. Cut out by young Matthew Upson. Now Remy Gard. Parler making the run out towards the right-hand side. Keith Pearl going out to meet him. Throw in his Arsenal's. Dixon. Jilks is the Wolves player. It's another throw.
There's battles all over the field, and that's particularly one. Jilks and Dixon. Jilks played a lot of his career as a fullback, got lightning pace, and he'll have to stay. To, you know, he'll have to stay with Dixon if Dixon decides to push forward.
Guard to his fellow countryman Petit. Stop the shot completely. The Wolves have a chance to break, and the ball is at the feet of Robbie Keane. Havard Flo. Keane has gone off. Cross comes Adams. Well, that will be part of Robbie Keane's education today. It's almost an eliminator for a centre forward to move up into the Championship ranks. An afternoon in the company of the Arsenal back four.
If you can hold your own against them and stand up and make an impression, then you really do belong in the top flight of the game. There's his manager, Colin Lee.
Yeah, Adams has had to switch across to compensate for Keown today. Normally Adams will occupy the left-hand side at the back, but he's played, he's gone over to the right-hand side, the position Keown normally plays in.
Emblem. It's come for Winterburn now. Now Overmars. Bergkamp. Petit. It's a rather loose one from Emmanuel Petit, just behind Havard Flo. Just as last year, Arsenal used the Christmas programme as a launching pad for a winter offensive on the twin peaks of League and Cup. 5 wins and a draw in their last 6 matches. Not since the early 80s has a team retained the FA Cup. A team called Tottenham Hotspur. Overmars just selling Dixon a little short, resisted the attentions of Jilts. And now for Costa. Muscat here against Dixon. Free kick has been awarded to Arsenal. Kevin Muscat is combative, to say the least.
Yeah, definitely budged in unnecessarily as well, because Anelka was going nowhere. Built up a little bit of pressure on his own team. Is this the one Adams spins round the back?
Adams is forward, Upson is forward. Petit in towards Tony Adams. Ron Atkinson read it, but thankfully for Wolverhampton Wanderers, so did Dean Richards.
Yeah, it's a good ugly ball in from Petit, taking out all the defenders. He spun the run, and as you say, at least the central defenders just managed to hang on to him and make it hard for him. But it was still a good chance. I must admit, when I saw Adams converging on that, I thought he was going to score. Yeah, full marks. Richards bulked him a little bit. I don't think Adams has scored those in his career.
Flo. Played quite an imposing style up the front, the Norwegian.
I think he should try and put himself against Upson as much as possible. Because one of his strengths, Flo, is the fact he is in the air.
Just getting the ball down there and feeding Emblem. Winterburn's clearance. Osborne, calmly done. Lifted forward towards Keane. Upson was the man who was in the way. Overmars caught by Atkins. Good advantage played by Steve Dunn. Bergkamp has found Parler. Plenty happening, right hand left. Looks for Overmars to his left, but Atkins managed to recover. Now Robinson. They get another chance. Richards, Emblem. Flo is in an offside position.
Yeah, not a lot changes, does it? 4 good defenders and Tony Adams is right hand and they're defending.
Given away by Overmars to Osborne. One back by Bergkamp. Richards got close to him and Bergkamp had a bit of a swipe at Dean Richards there.
Now Dennis isn't all that placid, you know, he does have that short fuse.
Well, it was evidenced in the quarter-final replay at Upton Park last season when a stray elbow cost him his place against Wolves in the semi. Bergkamp, a more familiar pose, feeding Parler. Oh, it was a late flag there, it is offside. And Nelka tucked it away. No goal.
Super finish, though. I wonder if he'd have been quite as calm. I wonder if he realised he was offside, because he took it very nonchalantly. He is just about offside. Not that much in it. That some linesmen may have let that go, but that's a good tidy tuck, isn't it? I wonder if it'd have been, if he hadn't been aware of the fact he was offside, whether he'd taken it quite so calmly.
I think he'd struck the ball before the flag went up. But Wolves have tried to force the issue against Adams and co, but they've had an early reminder there as to the quality that Arsenal possess.
Talked about the problem they might have with Parler pulling off the line, you know. The other one, of course, is Bergkamp. He goes into that little position, just short of the strikers. At the moment, let's just see this one through. At the moment, with Wolves not having a holding player in midfield, Bergkamp's going to get this sort of space.
trying to feed the pace of Anelka. Mike Stowell, the Wolves goalkeeper, was alert. Curl. Flo just managed to keep that in. Did well. This is Muscat. Now Key. Behind Osborne, and Anelka is first with the ball, and Petit has a chance to launch a counter. Bergkamp. Muscat is the defender. Cut out by Curl. Flo. Down to Emblem. Petit just managed to nick the ball away from him. Parler has now found Dixon. Bergkamp was leaning into Curl and conceded the free kick. This is Michael Jilks. Run down a bit of a cul-de-sac by Gard and by Dixon. Wolves have won three and drawn one of their last four games. Their season has been another of snakes and ladders. There have been a few false dawns at Molineux since they last rubbed top division shoulders with the likes of Arsenal 15 years ago now. But the FA Cup has provided some recent reminders of the high life, three quarter-finals in that Villa Park semi in the last five seasons. Robinson. Turned away by Petit. Good control from Osborne under pressure. He was just caught by Carr, but he's managed to nick it in towards Robinson, who missed his kick, and both Flo and Keane were spare beyond the far post. Good pressure this time from Osborne. Trying to feed Keane. Adams in the way. Overmars. It's quite an open match. Parler to his right, and Anelka to his left. Still Mark Overmars. He's scored! Arsenal in front inside 10 minutes. It's Mark Overmars. Precise low shot which defeated Mike Stowell and gave Arsene Wenger's cup holders the perfect start here at Molineux.
Yeah, I think Colin Lee might ask a few questions here though. I mean, it's a good burst. It's probably the first time he's picked up and ran with it. They've been occupied a little bit because he's shaped to play it right, to Parler on his right. But instead of going and closing the ball out, they've allowed him a shot from 20 yards and it's gone in for them. But I mean, he's virtually ran unchallenged, you know, from the halfway line on that. The people have run alongside him, but nobody's really got up and tried to work the ball at him. You don't invite a fella like him too many times to do that.
Well, Mark Overmars, who scored the opening goal in last season's final, who's actually scored four times now in his last seven matches, including one at Preston in the last round, has reversed the trend from that tie when Arsenal went two down inside 20 minutes at Deepdale. They're one up inside 10 minutes here at Molineux. And Anelka trying to cause them another problem.
There is a theory about Overmars, of course, because he's got this blistering pace and you're terrified of him going down the outside of you, that you push him in field and push him into a crowd of players. But I think when he goes in field like that, it's not enough to send him in field. Then you've got to work the ball again. You've got to try and close the ball out.
He had a good January last year. I think his first half season with Arsenal was a little disappointing, but he got amongst the goals in January last year and his season really took off from there. Anelka catching Curl up all the time, and Curl is no slouch.
I think you'd find as well with the goal, you know, if we looked at it from a distance, the impact, if you like, or the effect that Parler had without even getting a touch of the ball. He made a long run, which just did enough to take the cover off. It meant that the Wolves defenders had a distraction. They didn't know whether Overmars was just going to slide the ball right for Parler, and just that may just have freed him enough to get his shot in.
Jilks, trying to feed Flo, cut out by Upson. Took the lead in a similar stage of last season's semi-final at Villa Park. Wolves had no answer. Have they today? Emblem with the optimistic effort from range.
Yeah. A little bit of composure there, you know. He had Keane to his left. He might have just gone on with that, Neil Emblem, and played Keane in.
Ran a long way with the ball, didn't he?
Now, let's see. I don't think there's anybody even contest the ball. Look at Parler there. He's making the run. Defenders have got half an eye on him in case he slides it. He's now run that 70 yards, and you know, at some given time, a defender's got to step forward and try and make him hurry the ball a bit. Even if he forces him into an error, forces him to overrun it.
Winterburn. Overmars. Petit. Head out by Richards. Spoon forward by Adams. Well, there was an even earlier goal at Old Trafford in today's first FA Cup tie, and that was far from decisive. We'll be able to see the goals from Manchester United versus Liverpool a little later when we finish with Wolves and Arsenal. And Wolves certainly aren't finished here yet. This is Carl Robinson. Header away by Tony Adams. Mark Overmars, the scorer of the Arsenal goal. Played behind Dennis Bergkamp. Oh, and Muscat went sliding in and caught Bergkamp. And Kevin Muscat really does have a pretty dire disciplinary record again this season.
Yeah, I think he's on sudden death now, Kevin Muscat. I think next time, any sort of challenge that's a little bit out of order, he'll get done for.
He was before the Football Association last season, and one more booking again this season, and he'll be making a return trip to Lancaster Gate. Arsenal looking to consolidate now. Overmars back to Upson. Adams to Winterburn. Anelka. Given away though. Emblem has found Keane. Now Jilts. Taking on Dixie for pace. Michael Jilts spotting his cross. Oh, and he actually hit the crossbar. Manninger thought he had it covered. But the ball passed the hand of the young Arsenal goalkeeper and struck the face of his crossbar from Michael Jilts.
But I think that's something Jilts was always able to do, particularly as a youngster. I think he's going to do it even more today, and that's to face up Dixon and Trump.
Here's Petit looking for Anelka. Stowler is outside of his penalty area. The flag is up.
Yeah, I think Jilts has got to try and do more of that, Clive. Try and engage Dixon, make Dixon defend. Look at this, the ball in it, as you say, it's completely deceived Manninger. And on another day, when your day's in, that could have just dropped to one of your strikers.
Encouragement for Wolverhampton Wanderers. A goal down inside 10 minutes to Mark Overmars here at Molineux.
It should, as I say, be some encouragement to Michael Jilts. He knows now that he's got the pace to take Dixon on.
There's the chairman, president of Wolverhampton Wanderers in the interview shot, Sir Jack Hayward, who took over from his son early last season. Keane, his most prized asset. Osborne thought about his shot. Stead-fed Atkins, rolled back into Keane offside.
I just wonder whether Keane was offside then. You know, some slick passing. Keane had made a good little position. The other three or four, oh, yes, he's a mile off. I knew that the other attackers on the far side were, but he's a mile off as well. Good spot ref, or linesman.
The Arsenal formation hand-raising team were spot on again. They don't need a linesman. And flag is out at the other end now. Wanderers supporters trying to lift their team from the disappointment of conceding an early goal here. Dean Richards has gone forward for a free kick, which Keith Kerr will take. Came off the head of Petit, dealt with by Adams. Winterburn still has some work to do, as found only Robinson. Now Keane. Atkins. Robinson. Clever move, he was caught by Petit. Free kick. And the card's out here.
I think he's unlucky here, Petit. I think it's a free kick, but I think the brilliance of Robinson's done him here, you know. Atkins slides him in completely. I think he's just completely wrong-footed in there.
Yellow card for Emmanuel Petit. Did well to make any kind of contact with Robinson, really. It was such a clever, deft manoeuvre by the young Welshman. Now, what kind of platform has it provided for Wolverhampton Wanderers? Osborne and Jilks are the two men standing over the ball. Jilks the left footer, number seven, but it's Osborne. Found a way through and Robinson had a swing at it.
Yeah, it's an awkward one for him to deal with. He just gets the little nick and comes over the top of the defence. Incidentally, you see the defence up again in the line as soon as the ball's done and try to catch people offside. It's a hard one for Robinson to keep over, but certainly that little bit of cameo of skill he's just shown there was brilliant.
Wolverhampton Wanderers are the second best supported team in the Football League behind Sunderland. Nobody here will thank me for pointing out the obvious that it's waiting to happen again in this part of the Black Country, but they have been waiting for a long, long time now. Muscat made contact with the ball that time. Bergkamp trying to thread it through towards Anelka, cleared by Robinson, up towards Flo. Adams got in front of him. Endlin trying to burst onto the ball. Might come for Flo. Adams recovered well.
I say I will see him more effective in that role, you know, Endlin, when he's playing for Wolves in that midfield area. Breaking on, and he's a big, powerful lad. He's got a fair amount of pace. You know, and midfield players like that can cause defenders a lot of problem when they come running into the box late at them.
Osborne to Atkins. Now Robinson. For Arsenal. Good in possession, young Matthew Upson too. Very cultured young left-footed defender. That's a dangerous driven cross too, which Keith Hill did well to deal with. Nicholas Anelka waiting behind him.
I tell you, the older Wolves fans will think that was Jimmy Mullen going past and flashing a left-footed cross. That was a beautiful piece of play from the young defender.
He
looked very easy, didn't he, as he ran the ball. As you were commenting about the fact he's comfortable on the ball, he ran it very easy. I think it's strange enough, I think Arsenal in the last third have been very untidy, you know. I think they've given the ball away an awful lot.
Jets looking for Keane. A little isolated for the moment, Robbie Keane. It was Remy Gard who got back to make an important challenge just inside of his own penalty area.
I'm amazed he came back in field, you know, Keane. I thought he had the defender 1v1. I thought he'd have been better trying to get at him rather than coming across the face of the defender. You know, you always give yourself a chance of a penalty or anything like that if you go directly at the defender.
So much has been said and written about Robbie Keane in the days leading up to this tie, and he's straining to make an impact here this afternoon.
I've seen plenty of him. He is a good, good player. I think it was Kenny Dalglish said before the match that he's as good as there is around, and he's really spot on there.
Marco Vermaas, the goal scorer, winning a throw-in for Arsenal.
When they get in at half-time or after the game and see that goal, you know, I think there's a few Wolves players will be disappointed. I bet they don't realise how far they let Overmars travel with it.
You think the goalkeeper will be amongst them?
There was a suggestion that it went in slowly, but it went in right in the corner. Oh, tell you what, talking of goalkeepers.
Ball didn't go out of play. Manninger managed to recover, but he's had a rather nervous start, Alex Manninger.
Yeah, well, I wonder whether Mike Stahl might have been a little bit caught by surprise, probably expecting a defender, or may not have even been able to see, you know, the defenders in front of him. May have seen it a bit late.
Robinson is trying to glance the ball on towards Flo. Ups and low to Winterburn. But the goalkeeper, who's looked rather hesitant here, is the one who has the clean sheet at the moment. But Wolves will take some encouragement from those couple of difficult moments that Alex Manninger has survived. Overmars towards Petit. Across comes Dean Richards. He was as highly prized as Robbie Keane a couple of years ago. It's been a couple of injury plague years for Dean Richards, but he's not 25 until June. He still has a lot of his career ahead of him. Parler. Now Adams. Trying to stroke it in towards Anelka, who is tussling with Pearl. Six of one, half dozen the other, says the referee. pretty streetwise, Keith Curl. Jilks. Awkward for Adams. That's not what he intended at all.
He might tell you it was. We might think it wasn't. I'll tell you what. When you're as good as he is, everything goes your way, doesn't it? I think he was trying to reach Rose Zed with it. Cool nonchalance. I do get the feeling with watching Arsenal that they've got about another gear and a half to go, you know. They look as if they're playing well within themselves at the moment.
Colin Lee is officially in temporary charge of Wolverhampton Wanderers until the end of the season, having succeeded his long-time partner, Mark McGee, in November. Bergkamp in towards Winterburn. Petit couldn't really make contact, but Anelka might. He has Bergkamp in support, and now Parler. But he shot away well then, Roy Parler, but it flew across and beyond Mike Stahl's goal.
Just feel if Anelka would have been a little bit lively there, he could have set up a good chance there. He looked a little bit leaden-footed there, and it's hard for Parler to get it out of his feet, and just a little toe punt at the end.
Certainly we have the atmosphere that we anticipated inside Molineux. The Wolverhampton Wanderers fans haven't lost heart. But Arsenal lead through a 10th-minute goal from Mark Overmars. This is Neil Emblin trying to burst beyond Remy Gard, who did well. Dixon to Parler. Bergkamp. Lucky to get away with that. It's come for Petit. Overmars goes on. Cut out by Mark Atkins. Plenty of fire in their bellies, plenty of hope in their hearts still, Wolverhampton Wanderers.
Yeah, the big thing is they mustn't go two down. You know, even if they get to the interval with the score at 1-0, they've always got a chance.
Anelka. Overmars. Dixon arriving in support. Parler drawing wide. Muscat was aware of that. A little sharp from guard to Dixon, Keane getting amongst it. Adams tidying up, now Winterburn. Bergkamp. Petit. This is Dixon. Parler. Guard. Petit. Lifted in towards Roy Parler.
He loves that ball, Petit. Little one, he just curls into what we call an old-fashioned inside right position when it's just outside the penalty box, hoping to get a runner coming in from the right on it.
Dixon.
It's frustrating this for Wolves at the moment. They can't get the ball back up to the Arsenal. You know, in a cup tie, if you're the underdog, you like to be carrying the fight, setting the tempo, but at the moment Arsenal are just happy. They're one up. You know how famous Arsenal are when they're one up, but they're keeping and just retaining the ball. Very difficult for Wolves at the moment to get any momentum going.
Your Nottingham Forest team were behind for about an hour last weekend against them, just 1-0.
Yeah, I mean, we chased them. We were in the second half, to be fair. We may have got something out of it, but what you can't do, it's very hard. It's very hard to go and chase the ball when they've got good possession and players over.
Wolves do have a free kick here.
Yeah, they could do with more of this. They could do with this sort of thing to build up pressure. You know, three or four more corners before the interval would be handy.
Richards and Emblin have joined Flo on the edge of the penalty area. Keith Curl takes towards Havard. Flo, a little too long for him. Petit stood his ground and won the throw-in. Actually, he hit the ball against Flo's face. He played actually wide on the right-hand side for Norway in the World Cup finals. He was a regular in all of their games, but he is a centre-forward by trade, as indeed are his two fellow international cousins, Torre Andre Flo, now Chelsea and Jostein Flo, who had a spell in English football with Sheffield United. Quite a family. Bergkamp feeding off a Nelke. Osborne did well to get to him. This is Richards. Looking for Keane. Hudson just got a touch. Still Robbie Keane, though. Nigel Winterburn getting more than a touch. Fine challenge. Keane stuck at it. Oh, he has been penalised, though. Maybe just have a little tug at Winterburn at the very end of the pursuit. Felt his collar. Fine rain falling at Molineux as Arsenal come forward with Nicolas Anelka running into Neil Emblem. Simon Osborne to Kevin Muscat, now Keith Curl, and here's Osborne again. Flow asking for it to feet this time. Laid off to Emblem. Dix has gone on to his left, gone into an offside position, and Emblem has to go on alone. Well, Petit and Adams are there for company. Ooh, the back pass was a little dangerous with Flow closing in. Manning had dealt with that well.
Yeah, I've got a feeling that Petit played that one a little bit blind. I'm not sure he did realise that his goalkeeper was being pressurised.
Sort of glimpses of daylight for Wolves in this first half, no more than that. They haven't had a clear chance to equalise as yet. But Arsenal haven't looked altogether secure. Remy Gart.
I think what they've done exceptionally well, Arsenal, very, very well anyway, they've kept Wolves away from the goal. Wolves have had some good one or two moments, particularly the thing when Jilts got through.
Flo trying to put Upson under pressure. It's come for Key. Robinson. Got away from Winterburn. Carl Robinson. It's towards Flo and a really good interception by guard. Michael Jilts. Hung up towards Robinson. Wolverhampton Wanderers' best moment.
Yeah, some great play by Robinson here. Not the header at the end, it wasn't the easiest to head it, but a little bit of skill where he sits Winterburn down. Whoops, here we go again. A beautiful ball in, and Gard does brilliantly get that. Gard, maybe Dixon might have got a second one. And look at Gard again. First man out and prevents us a clear position chip. And Robinson just spoons it over. But some, that's encouraging. The best moments Wolves have been a break off each flank. That one and the one Jilts made when he hit the bar.
Muscat forward.
And that'll encourage Robinson a little bit because that's, I think that's the first time he's really had a go at Winterburn.
Dixon put under pressure by Jilts. Richards getting in front of Bergkamp. Robinson getting to Winterburn again. The team has to help out. Parler, back to Overmars. Rode the challenge from Osborne. Parler is running free down the centre, instead it's out to Anelka on the right-hand side.
Oh, if he'd have spotted him in there, Overmars, if he'd have released Parler. Parler was running clean on goal.
Parler. Bergkamp. Overmars. Allowed to turn and face Dean Richards. Now Bergkamp. In towards Anelka, cleared by Kerr. Chance for Robinson to save a break. Flo wanted it short and clean.
Well, so did Keane. I'm a bit surprised you, Robinson. He was a fairly intelligent player. A bit surprised he threw that one away so aimlessly.
Colin Lee's team have been unable to build up any concerted pressure. Little moments, enough to keep Arsenal on their mettle, enough to keep up Wolverhampton Wanderers' hopes, but no period of pressure to really examine Arsenal. Overmars. Beckham. Into Parla. Little sharp for him, Muscat got in the challenge. Cleared by Jilks. This is Robbie Keane. Carl Robinson. Michael Jilks was asking for the ball. Parla got back. Here's Gard, who made that excellent intervention a few minutes ago. Fills in well for Arsenal, Remy Gard. This is his third season with the club. He's never played more than four games in a row. He's played in a variety of positions. They actually had to talk him out of retirement last season. A really good squad player. This is Keane. Now Atkins. Robbins. Keane again. Steps away from Gard. Not from Winterburn, though. Osborne. Atkins. Keane. Now Osborne. Robbie Keane again. Cut out by Remy Gard again.
A slack ball, wasn't it? Good little bit of setting up play, but a slack ball by Robbie Keane.
Atkins has found Osborne. Keane. Away from Winterburn, but not from Petit. Hudson wasn't aware that Flo was there. Last 10 minutes of a first half which has been pretty much to Arsenal's liking so far, from the moment that Mark Overmars gave them an early lead.
Yeah, well, they've been very professional. They, as I say, they haven't really attacked Wolves' goal that much. They've been very professional at the moment. They've stopped Wolves building up pressure on them, which, if you're the, as I say, if you're the underdog, you really want to be doing. Get your crowd lifted, get a feel of it, you can spring a surprise.
Muscat, in towards Flo, goalkeeper didn't get there, and Havard Flo has equalised for Wolverhampton Wanderers. It's the Norwegian's first goal for the club, in only his second game for the club. Colin Lee's team are level, and Arsene Wenger knows that Alex Manninger will have to take a share of the blame.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that's a good deep cross. He takes up a good position. He's done this once or twice, Sir Flo. Pull on the keeper, pull on the centre-back's shoulders. Manninger's got into no-man's land. If you're coming that far, goalie, you've got to make it yours. But Upson in the first place is ball-watching a little bit. But full marks, brave header. He's headed it from a distance. And he's, I mean, that's a good deep ball in.
Actually clipped the post on its way in by the head of Havard Flo. But Manninger knows that if a goalkeeper comes, a goalkeeper has got to get, and he didn't. Flo quite literally beat him to the punch, and Wolves the level. And the volume level inside Molineux has been considerably pumped up by that goal from Havard Flo. He scored a headed goal against Scotland during the World Cup finals, you may recall, right at the start of the second half of their match in Bordeaux. But after a rather rusty debut last weekend against Watford, he has made a quick impression on the Wolverhampton Wanderers supporters with the equalising goal here against Arsenal in this fourth round tie. There's plenty of him, 6'2". Launched himself in there, but big Alex Manninger didn't get there.
But the big thing for me was his starting position. Starting position, bravery, good deep ball, as I say. I think the young defender's ball watched, and I think the young goalkeeper's got himself in a no-man's land. But that's not taking anything away from Flo. I mean, all of a sudden, his team are right back in it from, I would have guessed, really looking down the barrel.
nearly back in it, but they have the win in their sails now. The momentum is with the team that equalises in these cup ties. The start of Liverpool. Free kick has to be taken a good 10 yards further back. It was Marc Overmars who gave Arsenal the lead, but the Dutch was effort cancelled out by a Norwegian. Two members of the World Cup finals cast now, only they're living here in England. What a pass that is towards Parler. Just about caught up with it. Curls clear and sliced. Bergkamp to Petit. Got his shot away and all the feet style on that near post. Just pulled it a yard or so wide at the left-hand post.
The surprise, that's a great ball from Bergkamp, but I wonder whether we're in line for one of Bergkamp's great volleys there, you know, when he came out. I thought Dennis will give this the full gun, but clever little side football off, and as you say, Petit almost got the keeper napping again.
Parler against Muscat.
Now I'll be interested now to see whether Arsenal can lift their game themselves. Because I got a feeling that they were playing a little bit in cruise control.
Keith Kerr up towards Havard Flo. Tony Adams won that one. Petit lost the ball back. And Simon Osborne was quickly in. And there's a snap about Wolves again now. And really, we haven't seen the best of this man, Keane, yet. They've got that particular race to play in this game in many ways. Here is Bobby Keane, just beaten to it by Remy Gard. Nigel Winterburn away. Petit, Emblem though came between Petit and Gard. Here is Keane. Now Atkins. Keane a little hemmed in that time. Atkins, Petit in the way, came off guard. Wolves will take the throw. Last 5 minutes of the first half. Came off Winterburn, Atkins went in strongly. Remy Gard, who's down. Some concern here for the Arsenal bench. I can certainly court guard. Gary Lewin providing the treatment. Arsene Wenger looking concerned on the Arsenal bench. That's where you use this, isn't it, Ross?
Sometimes. Has been known.
It looks like it's something they better run off, and there are only 3.5 minutes in this first half remaining before he can get some proper treatment from Gary Lewin. Adams towards Parler.
I wonder whether Arsene Wenger will wonder whether he's had enough out of Bergkamp and Elka, and even allowing for the goal, Overmars.
Way by Muscat. Flo just unable to keep the ball in play. We feel a little bit more at home now. How about Flo? He arrived just a couple of days before his debut last weekend after a pretty protracted transfer deal with his German club, Werder Bremen. The £700,000 fee was agreed before Christmas, but he's only been here 10 days. And he'll have had a 4 weeks training, a bit of time with Robbie Keane, a bit of time to get his feet under the table and feel at home, and now that goal will have made all the difference to him. Dixon. Still in a yard for himself, Lee Dixon. Oh, it came off the goalkeeper's chest as well for Wolves, but it came to Carl Robinson.
Yeah, big surprise bang from Lee Dixon there, and as you say, he's spilt it, the keeper's spilt it now. Fortunately for Wolves, the reaction came from their own defenders.
The famous left-foot shooting of Lee Dixon. Not. Guard will take the corner. In towards Petit. Some good defending there by Muscat. Another corner. Head away by Dean Richards. Simon Osborne. Now Robbie Keane. Oh, he was hit there by Winterburn. It's a bad challenger, and it's going to be a yellow card for the Arsenal left back.
No complaints whatsoever about that. It's blatant. I mean, sometimes defenders think the forward's going to move the ball, and I think Nigel made up his mind there that he's going to put the reducer into young Keane.
Caught his standing foot and caught it painfully. Good header by Upson. Robinson, though, to Keane. He's come up with a throw-in from that tight corner. But he's come up with a corner kick from that tight corner, has he?
What a time this would be if they could just put one under the bar here and get a crowd scene around it. The Richards, emblems, curl, people like that. Flo.
Last minute of the first half. Turned in by Jilks. Towards the head of Flo, who won it again under pressure from Adams, but because of Adams' pressure, couldn't direct it. Tony Adams felt that Havard Flo caught him in the face there with his elbow.
I think that's brilliant, me, seeing a defender, particularly one like Tony Adams, complaining about some physical treatment from a centre forward.
Needs protection, Tony Adams, for referees. Emblem, Osborne. He's kept things ticking over for Wolves, Simon Osborne. Here's Robbie Keane. Clean challenge by Overmars that time. Manninga got everything behind that. Richards header forward. It's come loose for Overmars. Richards got a piece of it. Curls header away as far as Ray Parlour. Lee Dixon. Parler selling guard short. This is Emblem. Now Robbie Keane. Muscat. Flo. Osborne. Only to guard this time. Parler. Bergkamp pulling wide. Jilks did really well there. Bergkamp dawdled on the ball.
I think they've been very, very sloppy in the attacking third, Arsenal. Give the ball around several times and haven't appeared to play with a great sense of urgency there.
Atkins. It's knocked into the corner for Robinson to chase. Upson had a 5-yard start on it.
Whether or not the goal, this early goal from Overmars, has lulled them into a little bit of complacency. And, you know, sometimes it's hard to pick your game up. You get into that sort of easy tempo, and it's not always easy. The break might be better for Arsenal than Wolves.
Robinson. Coaxed in towards Keane. Lovely control, Robbie Keane! Well, he did the first part of that exquisitely. The second part was a little bit more difficult, and he just couldn't quite execute the volley.
We'd have been talking a great goal here, though, wouldn't we? Left footed, would have the little pull down and then the flip over the keeper. We'd have certainly been talking an excellent goal there.
He is a nicely balanced player, though, genuinely two-footed. And that control with that outstretched left foot was out of this world. Well, when Arsenal scored inside the first 10 minutes, they seem to have set their stall out to run this game the way they wanted. Mark Overmars it was who gave them the advantage. But Wolverhampton Wanderers never accepted that verdict. And 10 minutes before the break, they managed to cancel out this very accurately struck low shot from Overmars with a headed goal set up by Kevin Muscat and executed by their Norwegian centre-forward Havard Flo. And at the break at Molineux, This fourth round FA Cup tie is tied. It's Wolverhampton Wanderers 1, Arsenal 1.
Welcome back to Molineux Stadium that's bursting with excitement here. It's Wolves 1, Arsenal 1 in this AXA-sponsored FA Cup fourth round tie. Kenny Dalglish and Gareth Southgate with a smashing tie now, Kenny, isn't it?
Yeah, there's been a few mistakes, but makes it have even been exciting. And Wolves have done very well. Arsenal got a good start.
They seemed to be in reasonable control, didn't they, for a while?
Yeah, I think they got the goal and they seem to relax a little bit. But all credit to Wolves, they're stuck at their task and they got themselves back in level.
It wasn't very good defending, Gareth, was it, for this goal by Mark Overmars? I didn't realise he picked it up in his own half.
Yeah, it was only when I saw it again that you realised how far he's run with it. You're looking to... We said before the game, and Kenny said before the game, he was the man that Arsenal had to stop, and Wolves had to stop, and as soon as he picked it up, we were saying, well, here we go. But you look at it here and you think, well, someone's got to come, and even if they don't get the tackle in, make him make a mistake or make him push it too far, and someone else can clear it up. But he's run a hell of a long way without a challenge.
Neat finish, Kenny, isn't it?
That's a great finish, but Keith Carroll's got a lot of pace, and he's backed off him. I think young boy Carl Robinson's trying to get in front of him at the start of the run. He's turned him and get running at the defence, but I can't understand why Keith Curra wants to go that far back.
Simple goalkeeping mistake for the equaliser?
It is a mistake, but I think it's a good ball in for Kevin Muscat. It's beat the option, and I think the goalkeeper realises it's beaten option, and maybe he's trying to rescue the situation. But certainly, he's come out and he's trying to punch it for his shoulder.
He looks to me a little bit, Gareth, as if Upson's actually stopped, as if he's got a call from Manninger.
Yeah, I mean, I think, without doubt, he's not made an attempt to jump there, so he must have had a shout from behind. But it's the old story, if you come as a keeper, you've got to make it. And no doubt you'll be having a word with him about that in the morning, Bob.
Well, Monday at least. Should we make it Monday? Or Tuesday?
It's tomorrow.
It is tomorrow. Yeah, well, we play it till we're Sunday, it's okay. Wolves deserve it in a way because they came close. There were a couple of other occasions. Yeah.
Well, this is a cross from Jilks in the left wing here. And I think you could be working in crosses on Monday morning as well, Bob. I mean, it's difficult.
That's just a cross, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not a shot. I don't think his vision's that good that he's going to try and score for there. But I think the goalkeeper could have been moving his feet a wee bit quicker here.
Great defending by Remy Gard on this initial cross, Gareth.
Yeah, superb. I mean, Arsenal's midfield do a great job for them. Petit gets back so well. And Gard there again, great defending from a midfield player. And that ball was just in the air too long for Robinson to be able to keep the header down, really. But I was impressed with Wolves the way they came back into it. I mean, when I saw them last year, they didn't really have a go at Arsenal in the first half. But in spite of the fact they went behind, they kept at it well.
What's the outcome here? Can Wolves win this game?
Well, they can certainly win it, but I think with the pace and Elke and Overmars up front, Bergkamp's no started to play yet, really. And you always think, they're always threatening, aren't they? Even if they're doing nothing, you always think that they're going to do something. And I would think that Bergkamp's going to come into the game at some stage, and you think that might be the threat for Wolves. But certainly, it's not beyond them.
OK. Well, a place in the fifth round is the prize for today's winners. On Wednesday evening, however, a Wembley final beckons as the Worthington Cup reaches the semi-final stage.
What a good place to be. Don't believe a hat.
Make space for the shot. Oh! It's Wolverhampton!
Well, the first leg at White Hart Lane in 3 days' time. Right now here at Molineux with 45 minutes still to play, it's Wolverhampton Wanderers 1, Arsenal 1. It should be quite a second half. Wolverhampton Wanderers 1, Arsenal the cup holders 1. Let's hear now from the Wolves assistant manager, John Ward. He's with Gary Newbon.
John, what were you concentrating on at half-time?
Well, we need to stay with the game. The first 20 minutes of the first half there, the pace of the Arsenal side took us by surprise. I mean, it's a lot quicker than we used to at Division 1 level, but we've stayed with it, and it's really important that the first 20 minutes of this half that we stay very well organised to try and keep with the game again.
From Arsenal's point of view, it's probably a good time to come to half-time, but you didn't really want to stop that, did you?
No, when you pull a goal back at that particular time, perhaps another 10 minutes to see if we could get anything out of them, but as I say, we've got to now be aware of that they got time to regroup, and I say we've got to make sure our organisation's absolutely spot on, otherwise they'll pass us off the pitch.
Now, Arsenal will complain at their goalkeeper, surely, for coming out, but Flo was very brave, John.
Yeah, that's why we signed him. I mean, I hadn't seen him, but Colin Lee had seen him play, and he knew that he was very good in the air, and you don't get anything if you don't go in for it. I mean, what we have found in the week that we've had him working with us, he's a very brave boy. He's took a little bit of a knock himself, but I'm pretty sure he'll be out there going again.
So how do you see the second half now?
Well, like I say, we've got to make sure that we keep the tempo if we can, and make sure we look after the ball a little bit better. We've worked so hard to try and get it back off them that sometimes we rush ourselves and lose possession of the ball. So we need to keep organised, and we try and keep our possession a little bit tighter if we can.
And there's always the threat, of course, that Arsenal are going to step up a gear.
Oh, well, yeah, I mean, we're enjoying every minute of it. I mean, on the bench, I'm so thrilled, really, seeing the pace of these types of players, these world-class players. But it's a real good experience for our boys, and hopefully we can stay with it.
Thank you very much indeed, John. Let's return now to our commentary team. Here's Clive.
Thanks. Thank you, Gary. John Ward has been involved in an FA Cup final. He was Graham Taylor's assistant with Watford back in 1984 against Everton, and came here on a temporary basis at the start of last month, having left Bristol City in October following the arrival of Benny Lennartsen. John Ward is still hoping to get back into the game with a number one job soon. Colin Lee's position has not yet been confirmed with Wolverhampton Wanderers for next season, but a good result here this afternoon wouldn't do his CV any harm. The club have no fewer than 15 players out of contract at the end of the season, and of course those players are already in a position where they can start to negotiate with potential future employers. But the medium term is the last thing on their minds at the moment. It's here and now. Wolverhampton Wanderers have the opportunity to muscle in on Fulham's FA Cup headlines. There were five ties between Premiership and First Division teams yesterday, and the big boys won all five. Even the top two in the Football League, Sunderland and Bradford, were beaten. But by the law of FA Cup averages, you would think that somebody else should be able to make an impression. And maybe the laws of the FA Cup are slowly changing. It's up to Wolves to challenge that. It'll be an interesting barometer this second half, of the difference between the top flight and those striving to get there. Tony Adams up towards Nicholas Anelka, who's a rather muted force in the first period. Simon Osborne, who saw a lot of the ball in that first half, on the ball again. Jilts, keen down the touchline. Arsenal throw. Have had their hands full with Football League opponents in recent years. Bolton, Millwall, Sheffield United have all knocked them out of the FA Cup. Port Vale came within a couple of penalties of repeating the dose last time. This is Parlour. Overmars beaten to it by Atkins. Can Wolves pick up where they left off? Can Bergkamp here make more of an impact on the game? Muscat's all over him again. No free kick. Bergkamp holding his face. Still down.
That Muscat's no respecter of reputations, well, is he?
He is, like you say, a competitive type player. Millions of bookings, it seems, in the course of a season, and he's obviously had a little bit of contact there with Dennis.
There was a grapple going on.
Oh, forearm in the face of Bergkamp. Muscat's lucky.
I know it sounds strange. I wonder whether that was accidental or, you know. I mean, there's always a reaction. But when players are grappling like these with, arms can be flying anywhere. I'm not so sure that that was a deliberate whack, you know. If it was, he did it very, very cleverly.
He has had the finger pointed at him a couple of times in the last year or so. It was a tackle on Matty Holmes in the FA Cup at this stage last season, which put him out of action for a long time. And Craig Bellamy, the young Norwich City player, had an altercation with Muscat just last month.
It was certainly a vigorous challenge, the one in Bellamy was. But that one, they were both having a little grapple there, both Bergkamp and Anton. You like to give the lad the benefit of the doubt when he swung round Muscat.
I'm not sure that Bergkamp would
quite sure
charge
that. I'm not sure Dennis would.
Just counting his motors and incisors at the moment.
Sometimes to win the FA Cup, you have to give blood, don't you? Tried his little trick again there, Robinson, with Petty wasn't behind him that time.
Adams. God. Showed too much of that to Neil Andrew. Looking for Keane, but Matthew Upson was there. Here is Muscat, now Osborne, Richards, Atkins, drove that against Overmars, and Anelka was quickly there, gets it back from Petit, Overmars, drifting in field again, guard, through towards Parler, Keith Kerr across, managed to dig the ball out. Muscat trying to tidy up. Only for guard though. Now Dixon. Jibs and Dixon have never been far apart this afternoon. Bergkamp is back with us. I think that somebody on the Arsenal bench will have had a word with Bergkamp too, just to make sure that he doesn't try to exact his own form of punishment. Run away from Petit. This is Robinson. Now Robbie Keane with a little bit of grass in front of him. Run away from Adams, taking on Upson. Flo. That's a lovely ball in towards Robinson, and Winterburn recovered really well. Good vision though from Havard Flo.
Oh, it's a good break from Wolves that. For all the world you thought that Robinson was going to get a little ball dropping over Winterburn's shoulder, and he just managed to get the faintest of touches on it, Winterburn.
This is Bergkamp. No stitches in that gash on the inside of his bottom lip, but he's found Parler here. Guard. Now Petit.
I think this is what John Ward was referring to at half-time, that when they do start the passing sequences going, Arsenal, that none of the Wolves players get pulled all over the place. They've got to just stay in the positions and don't let them move you.
We've got a couple of men around Bergkamp there that time. Arsenal got it back with Parler. Here's Bergkamp again. Little back heel meant for Remy Gard, but well seen by Emblem. Good work by Emblem, sidestepping Petit. Showed too much of it there to Winterberg. Emblem thought he was held back. Instead, it's Overmars on the ball. This time, Atkins cutting it out for Wolves. Osborne. Emblem. Osborne out to Jilks. Driven in diagonally, but catching Flo offside.
That's a particularly good ball, you know. I mean, the goal might have been a little bit of that. Hitting the ball, if Wolves hit the ball from left to right, they automatically miss Tony Adams out, who's the biggest header, you know, he's their best header. If they can keep, if you like, eliminating him on the crosses, it gives them an even money chance of getting something like they do with Flo there for the goal.
Ray Parler, Lee Dixon, into Dennis Bergkamp, let it run. And Elka just unable to feed off him. Maybe he can feed off Petit here.
That's the little ball I mentioned first half. He does it, and it seems when he's midway in the attacking half, he always looks to thread that one, Petit, that little curly chip into the inside right position.
Pepper down to Bergkamp. Parlour with some space now to his right. Pass just a little too strong, but it was a well-struck cross shot from Ray Parlour, which Mike Stell held on to at the second attempt. Adams, Petit, Bergkamp. Slid through to guard. On towards Anelka. It's Nicholas Anelka. Well, he got the old curl. He got in front of Stahl. It was a sharp chance. And Nicholas Anelka couldn't quite find the target.
Yeah, some smart football there from Arsenal. One or two quick one-touch passes. Remy Gard, a great ball over the top of curl. His touch, keeper's out. Keeper's done just enough to put him off there because his touch wasn't that bad. This is the one earlier. Little threaded ball. He's got it all on there, Ray Parlour, to get his shot in, and that's twice that he's spilt balls there, and you just wonder, you know, in the days of Ian Wright, there'd have been a red and white shirt hovering around that, wouldn't it? You know, whether Arsenal lack somebody of that sort of type that goes in and gets, if you like, scruffy goals.
Well, it's an old debate. Ian Wright currently resting up after a knee operation, although the very thought of Ian Wright resting up is impossible to imagine. He'll be jumping around his living room at the moment. Here's Parlour. Bergkamp. His run was blocked by Muscat, but Bergkamp's return pass was too strong. Mike Stahl missed out on the semi-final last season. Hans Sager, as you may recall, was Wolverhampton Wanderers goalkeeper for both the semi and the quarter when he made a crucial penalty save from Jimmy Hasselbaink. Robbie Keane. Cross came Winterburn crucially. First. Second glimpse of goal ready for Keane.
As Dennis having a look, making sure he's protecting himself there against Kirk.
This is Parlour. Here's Bergkamp. That's nicely angled towards Anelka, just beyond him.
Just harking back a second there, you know, Clive. Winterburn has made many, many challenges, many, many sort of retrieving situations. He ain't made too many better than that one he's just made. That looked a very, very good opportunity for Wolves if he hadn't have got there.
Muscat. In towards Flo. Well controlled. How about Flo? At the post. Not even lucky. And pulled away by Hudson. How about Flo? Cannot believe his luck. Did everything right there. Marco Ramos on the counter for Arsenal. Remy Gard. Now Dennis Bergkamp. Blocked by Keith Curley. He's got a free kick. Bergkamp's getting angry here. Carbon flow. Well,
so there it is. Carbon copy ball through. Good control. And for all the world, you think he's going to score. And I actually thought Manning was going to knock that into the path of Keane.
He was soundly beaten there, but the ball bounced back off the post towards Alex Manning. It's his opposite number, Mike Stahl, who has the problem though now as Wolves line up to face his free kick, for which Bergkamp must be the favourite. It's indirect. Overmars, guard, Bergkamp! Stahl got everything behind it.
Yeah, a little bit in keeping with the way Dennis has played today, wasn't it? Ineffective. But you know, if you went back to that chart opportunity before he has rolls, he tries to curl it around the outside of the wall, no problem for Stahl at all. If you went back to that movement, you know, when Flo has just hit the post, have a look at the situation when the ball's played into him. There's two over, you know.
Offside here.
There's actually another player, Wolves player over. Even if Flo had missed the original ball, it would have been a great position for Wolves. And I just wonder where Arsenal's defence had gone to then. Somebody slept.
They've just been a bit loose today, Arsenal, in all areas of the field.
I actually think defensively it's got a lot to do with Tony Adams switching from the left to the right.
Well, Matthew Upson is naturally left-footed, so...
Yeah. Oh, they would have to do that. And I know Tony Adams has played a lot of times, and he's naturally a right-footer. But sometimes defenders playing at the back in the centre are happier with it playing on the, you know, on their opposite foot, if you like.
Last couple of years have been frustrating for Havard Flo in Germany. He's been in and out of the Werder Bremen team. He found the tempo of football in the Bundesliga not altogether to his liking, but he's loving this.
I tell you what, he'll appreciate the sort of service. All right, we've talked about Muscat, about one or two of the incidents, but certainly the ball for the goal in that one, he will love that sort of service, because remember him playing for Norway in the World Cup. Every time Bjørneby got the ball, he just lashed it across, and Flo, as you said, was coming in from a right-hand position every time.
He used to do that with Jostein Flo, didn't they? Play him right out on that right-hand side. Remy Card, first of the ball. Ray Parler. Got his cross away. Gets the second chance. It's Lee Dixon, well struck. And Mike Starr reacted well, and so did Dean Richards.
Yeah, good shot from Dixon. Good. You know, he's got down. It's that little one that's gone loose into the pack again, though. Shoots across his body. Right place. That's the rebound. Here he comes, Dixon. Keeps it down well. Just can no red and white shirt to button onto the end of it.
Winterburn's cross. Nobody in the centre. The run for Parler. Here's Dixon again. He might fancy another pot. Petit. Winterburn. Osborne did well.
I think what they appear to be doing, Wolves, you know, when they lose it, when they fall back into their defensive shells, they want to make sure that there's a bit going off now with Curl and Dixon. Oh, I think they're all, they've kissed and made up. And they're always making sure that they've got a fair number of bodies in the middle of the goal, because I think they can then afford to say to Arsenal, go on, throw the ball into the box and we'll do you in the air. We'll be betting you in the air.
Over 2 years since Lee Dixon scored, it's 8 years since he scored in this competition, but you wouldn't know it on today's evidence. He's shots away with right and left foot.
Funny old thing is, that's when you automatically assume he gets four or five goals a season, don't you, Dixon?
Well, he used to score 10 penalties once upon a time, but lost that honour. Osborne. Straight to Parler. Breakdown of communication in the Wolves midfield. Parler trying to roll all the way. Muscat, who came across and did well. Jilks. Keane flicking it on. Upson responding. Both sides have had moments in the second half to encourage them to think this could be their day.
I certainly think since the break that Arsenal have driven the game a little bit more, but they've left themselves vulnerable, as we've just seen. You know, at the moment they're playing more like the home team, Arsenal.
We've had an hour, it's 1-1. Mark Overmars after 10 minutes, equalised by Havard Flo 10 minutes before the break. Here is Overmars. Winterburn lending support. They do well to catch up with Overmars, though.
That's that untidy one again. I tell you, they pushed him in field. He's been very, very untidy there, Overmars. I'm still a bit surprised. I know you're talking about Winterburn making a big overlap run. I'm still a bit surprised that Overmars doesn't try and have a go at the outside of the defence. He's quick enough and well good enough to.
Keane held up by Parler. Anelka. Muscat leaning into Parler and making that his. Robbie Keane. Curl away. Only as far as Adams. Now Petit. Oh, Flo was there. Upson won't thank him for that headed pass. Wait by Richards, on by Endlin. Only as far as Upson. Petit. Lovely ebb and flow about the game now. Overmars. Petit. Anelka.
I think if you're playing against Overmars, you're more than happy to see him just drop the little ball either inside to a midfield player or back to his fullback, you know. What you don't like when Overmars is playing against you, you don't like him roaring at you and sitting you on your backside sort of thing.
Parler to Gard. Just opened up there for Remy Gard momentarily. And now for Nicholas Anelka. Through the goalkeeper's legs, players already stopped. It was offside. Dean Richards managed to hook it off the line anyway, but all that was irrelevant once the flag had been raised.
Yeah.
Ooh, he was level.
Yeah, it's a good little ball as well. It's a good little ball up from Remy Gard. I think what you have to say as well, though, so there's no arguments, at least Wolves saw it off. It wouldn't have been a goal.
And in fairness to the man with the flags, a yard either way, and it's an impossible call, and that was a close one. Nothing came of it, as it happens. defence to Parler. Looking for Overmars, over the head of Mark Atkins. Lovely pass. Overmars jabbed infield towards guard, cleared by Kerr. This is Winterburn. Now Bergkamp. Winterburn has gone on. Emmanuel Petit. Winterburn. Played inside the fullback to Overmars.
Poor ball.
He's got another chance. Curl blocked this one. Richards blocked the first. Out as far as Bergkamp. Awkward save by Stahl. And Muscat it was, who hooked it away. I don't think Mike Stahl saw that until very, very late. Sweet strike from Dennis Bergkamp.
Yeah. Two poor balls, actually. Both got charged down. That was a lucky ricochet, but that's Bergkamp. That's vintage Bergkamp. Great shot. Instant trigger. Fortunately, Stahl was able to just get a block on it.
Remy Gard with the corner. Kevin Muscat with a header. Emmanuel Petit back out to Gard on the left flank. This time, Dean Richards deals with it. It's Robbie Keane for Wolves. Michael Jilks. Trying to run Bergkamp. Havard Flow. Ran away from him to Nigel Winterburn. A little touch from Flow. Winterburn still in possession. Referee happy for him to go on. Wins the throw from Atkins. Still more than 25 minutes to play. It'll be a difficult call as to which way this game will turn.
I mean, territorially now it's all Arsenal. But there's always that little threat, isn't there, whether it's Keane, Flo, or... I still think Emblem's got a burst in him that can carry him from midfield.
Arsene Wenger, who enjoyed himself so much at Wembley last May. So did Nicholas Anelka here.
It's funny how the pendulum swings as well. Talking to Arsene before the game, he was saying how he would have loved that Liverpool-Man United game to be a draw, because obviously the vested interest in an extra game for them. Now, you know, he's looking down the same situation.
Last English manager to win the FA Cup, Ron? Oh, your very best pals in football. Oh, you're usually good at quizzes too. Joe Royal. Since then, Alex Ferguson, Ruud Gullit and Arsene Wenger.
I thought he was the last member of the Royal Family. I thought he was the last member of the Royal Family to win it.
Free kick to Wolves. Dean Richards has sprinted forward. Big man. It's Keith Curl's free kick. In towards Neil Emblem.
That's the clever one. Just, I wondered about that. You talked about Dean Richards coming up. Dean Richards has come up just to pull Tony Adams, who is Arsenal's biggest size, if you like, pull him right out to the side and play the ball into the middle. For Emblem that time, you've got the targets, Emblem and Flo. Quite happy to add Adams out of the danger area, if you like.
Petit, Muscat, Jilks. Dixon got in a challenge. Guard to Bergkamp. Now Dixon. This is Anelka. Slid back to Emmanuel Petit. Now Nigel Winterburn. Shooting, not quite matching his fullback partner as yet.
Yeah, but I tell you what, I think in the olden days, say Alan Smith had been playing, I think there'd have been no question Nigel Winterburn would have flown that into the middle of the box. They obviously realised that, right, Anelka's a big guy and Bergkamp's fairly tall, but they're not what you call total headers, are they? They prefer to have the ball fed in so they can get shots in.
Arsene Wenger still waiting to get his latest signing, Nwankwo Kanu, in action for Arsenal, waiting for a work permit for the Nigerian centre-forward, who he has likened to Alan Smith in style. We seem to see how that might change Arsenal's approach if he becomes a part of their late season challenge for the two trophies they currently hold. And their hold on the FA Cup is being challenged here by Wolverhampton Wanderers. Petino to Parla. Emden coming back with him. Arsenal throw. It's interesting, a year ago Arsenal were fifth in the league. They were still in the League Cup. Now they're fourth in the Premiership. The Worthington Cup is out of their reach. Their table is clear ahead of them. And they can find the same kind of form again. Dixon. Away by Curl. T-robbed by Flo. Now Osborne. Keane quickly tackled by Upson. Certainly hasn't let Arsenal down alongside Adams in defence, Matthew Upson. Keane back to Robinson. Here's Robbie Keane again. Trying to hold off Nicholson now, but he couldn't. On to now, Mark Overmars. All well saved by Stahl. Kirk Campbell's up with Overmars, but he was in time to get a shot away, and Mike Stahl got his angles right at the near post.
Yeah, stands up well here. Keith Kill's coming across, so he can't really cut back across, and as you say, good block from the goalkeeper.
Good work by Anelka there to win the ball for Arsenal from Keane. Arsenal have an edge in terms of the corner count. Guard takes. In towards Upson. Turned away by Atkins. Bergkamp hit it. It was deflected in it. I think it came off Havard Flow.
That's cruel.
Arsenal are back in front. Dennis Bergkamp's volley diverted beyond the helpless Mike Stahl. Ironically, I think it was the Wolverhampton Wanderers goal scorer, Havard Flo, who got that last crucial touch, trying to help out.
And the ball goes in, it's just dropped out now. Full marks here to Dennis Bergkamp. He hits it well, but he doesn't really, it's not one of his best shots. In fact, it looks as if it's got a double ricochet.
I think it came off Anelka last
time. Yeah,
didn't
I think
it?
It's got a double ricochet. There's the one, yes, I think it was. Was Anelka offside?
Right, it came off Flo, didn't it?
Yeah.
Arsene Wenger watching intently. And then celebrating openly the fact that Arsenal are back in front.
They've certainly dominated here, as I say, since half-time in terms of territory. I'm not so sure you got the feeling there was a goal on the card, you know.
Well, an element of fortune about the goal. Arsenal certainly had a territorial advantage in this second period. They now have a real advantage, and it's a big question as to whether Wolves can come back again.
I wonder whether Wolves might now take a little throw on, you know, probably possibly put Connolly up front and drop Keane in just behind the front two. I've seen Connolly and Keane play together earlier in the season, and some of their link-up play was excellent.
David Connolly, Keane's fellow Irish international, is one of the substitutes available to Wolves. They have the young German winger Robert Nistroy too from the right, and maybe Paul Simpson, the more experienced left winger, to come on the other flank.
I think I'd be, I certainly think if I was the Wolves manager now, I'd be maybe looking to take possibly Jukes off, who hasn't really, apart from that little run in the first half, hasn't really been involved in the game. I mean, his whole thinking now, Colin Lee's whole thing has got to change. I mean, at the start of this half, he'd be happy at 1-1.
Yellow card for Dennis Bergkamp.
He'd have been happy at 1-1 and maybe go back to a replay. That would have been a good result for Wolves. But now he's got to chase the game, and I think he's got to chase it with an extra front player. He's got to, once again, carry the fight as they did in the latter stages of the first half. As we say, Dennis can sometimes have a little bit of a short fuse.
It's a forward challenge.
I think that's a cliche, that, isn't it?
Forward challenge.
Get away with murder.
Nothing wrong with a cliche.
No, have a kick at him. Have a kick at somebody because you're a forward. It's a defender's shot and a forward's challenge.
Here is Bergkamp. That's a lovely touch for Parla. He's got beyond Muscat here. It's Ray Parla. Remy Garner was up in support, but the pass wasn't good. Atkins saw it. Given away there by Angler. Petit saw that. Anelka onside. Pulled back cleverly for Beckham.
Oh, that would have been vintage. That would have been vintage. That nice slick ball through from Petit. Anelka cut it back. That's a nice, good movement. Sputters badge there, cuts it back, and that would have been a lovely curly ball into the top of the net. That would have been a great goal.
Beckham couldn't quite finish off the two Frenchmen set up, two Frenchmen who were on international duty on Wednesday night in Marseille. France played Morocco and beat them 1-0. Petit came on at half-time for Didier Deschamps, and Nicolas Anelka came on midway through the second half in that game. Here is Petit, and it was Anelka. Instead, it was curled as far as Overmars. Osborne got back there. Arsenal looking to finish it off. Ray Parlour. Lee Dixon. Anelka. Next port of call, of course, for France is Wembley on February the 10th against England. Here's England under-21's Matthew Upson to England's Tony Adams. Upson's actually the only UK signing that Arsene Wenger has made for Arsenal, certainly until Germain Pennant the other week. All his other signings have come from the other side of the channel. Here's one of them, Anelka. This is the goal that separates the two teams. Who got the last touch, Ron? I think it was maybe Keith Curl in front of Anelka.
I still think it was a double ricochet, that.
Flo got his head to it, and then I think it just sort of came off the hip of Keith Curl.
Yeah, I think Flo was going to score. I think Flo had directed his header perfect, but I think Curl's helped him. But a cruel one. Not the best shot that Bergkamp's ever hit either. That won't bother him.
Robbie Keane. Mark Atkins. Arsenal have a problem with Remy Gard down at the moment.
That would be a blow for them because he's had a tremendous... I think he's been excellent for them today, Remy Gard. I mean, he is one of the very, very unsung players in the camp.
Arsenal looking for play to be stopped. Mike Stahl turning it out of play so that Gary Lewin, the physiotherapist, can come on and administer some treatment. Looks like the right ankle of Remy Gard, which is the problem for him and for Arsene Wenger now. Arsenal's route down Wembley Way was an away day excursion last year. They didn't win a single tie at Highbury. The Wolves have not lost at Molineux since September, and they have beaten five Premier League teams in this competition in the last five seasons.
I thought I just saw the physiotherapist give the manager the signal, and yes, he did, that it was all over, and Vivas is coming on.
Nelson Vivas, another World Cup player.
Yeah, I thought he would be on shortly, but I thought he might have gone on in place of Overmars as a tactical thing and sew the thing up in midfield.
Well, he's had a run in the team recently because of an injury to Nigel Winner, but at left back, Nelson Vivas. That's not really his favourite position. He played on the right of a back three for Argentina at the World Cup, although he lost his place after the England game when Nesta Sensini recovered fitness. Arsenal playing with 10 men for the moment, but now there'll be an opportunity for Vivas to come on. And there's the man who's going to be replaced. Vivas for Gard. It looks like Vivas is going to play on the right-hand side of midfield with Ray Parlour tucking in alongside Manny Petit. Change from Wolves yet. They need to change something. Trailing to Dennis Bergkamp's deflected goal in the second half. Still to come on ITV this afternoon. They draw for the fifth round of the competition, plus the pick of the goals from round four, including the three that decided the outcome at Old Trafford in dramatic fashion earlier today. Three more this afternoon. Arsenal leading by 2-1. Here's Havard Flo though. Upson is there. Now, is this a moment for Wolves?
This is similar to what happened in the first half. They built up a little bit of pressure, Wolves. They got one or two throw-ins in the last third. A couple of corners, and it enabled them to get the crowd momentum going again.
Atkins to Emblem. Now, I push him to them. Remy God's afternoon is over.
Nobody's done more than him, I don't think, for Arsenal today. I thought he had a smashing contribution.
Pell had the option to go back to his goalkeeper, but effectively what he has done by a rather roundabout route. Came off the head of Flo, didn't fall for Keane. I wonder if there's still a big moment ahead this afternoon for Robbie Keane. He was very much the focal point of all the pre-match hype. Arsenal rumoured to be one of the teams keen to sign him. This is Dixon, got away from Muscat. Not from Emblem, though. Clean challenge by Neil Emblem. This is Muscat. And out by Petit. Anelka is onside here. Turning away from Curl, running into Muscat, though. Adams. Petit. Muscat did well. Very well. It's found Michael Jilks. Good work by Ray Parlour that time for Arsenal. They really rolled their sleeves up since Bergkamp's goal there, protecting this lead with a little more earnestly than they did the lead that Overmars gave them in the opening moments of the first half.
Yeah, you got the distinct impression from half-time that they came out with a little bit more urgency. Oh, there's that lovely run from Overmars.
Stahl committed, used his head, quite literally.
Done very, very well, Overmars. Pulls towards the ball as Winterburn has it and then darts in behind it. That's something I haven't seen from him today. That's one of the first, apart from his goal, first positive runs he's made. And he is lightning quick. I mean, nobody can live with him when he decides to run at the back of people.
Here's Overmars. As John Ward, the Wolves assistant manager, was saying to Gary Newbon at the break, there is so much pace in the Arsenal team, particularly from Overmars and Anelka, and the speed at which they do things has made it difficult for Wolves to keep up with them at times today. Vivas the substitute. Bergkamp. Richards though for Wolves. One of their players whose contract is out at the end of the season. Jilks another. Atkins another. Really so like it's shown for Mark, but Anelka is offside here. But it is a problem for Coningley. Trying to make plans for next season. I'm wondering whether he's in those plans. He's got Steve Sedgley and Paul Simpson ready to come on. Two very experienced players. Carl Robinson and Michael Jilks are going to make way. The two wide midfield players towards go.
I just wonder whether he might go three at the back, you know. Just go three at the back and push everybody else forward.
Steve Sedgley, number 15, who was a cup winner with Tottenham Hotspur back in 1991. And Paul Simpson, another very experienced man. Once of Manchester City and Oxford and Derby. Sedgley making an immediate impact. Tottenham, of course, beat Arsenal in the semi-final that year in the Gascoigne semi at Wembley. He essentially played in that game. Colin Lee has played his cards. Passed a lot of Overmars, that pass. Away by Curl. Emlyn first to it, it ran for Ray Parler. Strong shot, but Stahl held on that time. Sisson has gone against Havard Flock. Neil Emblem, who's gone wide to the right-hand side with Sedgley.
He had a spell there a couple of years ago, just playing wide on the right. Not so much as a right-winger as he appears to be now, more as a wide midfield player. Looks as if they said to him, just stay up the field and...
Simpson's on the left, Sedgley alongside Osborne at the heart of it. This is Overmars. Tucked back to Anelka. Oh, good footwork from Anelka, good recovery by Richards. Still Nelson Vivas, though. Chance to finish it, blocked by Curl. Now Ray Parler. Arsenal will regroup. Vivas had the best opportunity there to Petit. Now Bergkamp.
Yeah, I thought we had visions of Ricky Vila there, you know. I thought he was just going to be turned inside Vivas. I thought he was going to do one of those sort of goals.
Well, he's had enough. I'll go and get the car started. 6 more minutes though for Wolves to make him regret his decision maybe. Muscat to Simpson. Driven in towards them, but Winterburn did enough. Adams completed the job.
Just looking at that left footed ball from Simpson, you know, whatever else, he's always had a very educated left foot. And I bet Colin Lee's hoping that he may get a free kick in just around the edge of the box areas. He can pop them.
Certainly, Paul Simpson's second appearance for Wolves this season. He spent much of this season on loan to Walsall, helping with their second division promotion push.
So, talking to Arsene Wenger before the game, he was on about, he thought Keown was probably the best defender in the country at the moment. And whatever else, I think they've missed him today. All right, they haven't been under a hectic pressure, but I certainly think they've missed his strength and power and heading ability.
Nothing much more now that Colin Lee can do to affect the outcome.
Well, he's gone positive now. He's got 3 up front, 3 in midfield, and four in midfield, basically. He is just more or less asking 3 to stay at the back.
Atkins. Tossed in towards Havard Flo. Adams did well. Bounced off Winterburn momentarily. Wouldn't come for Emblem, though. This is Osborne. Back in towards Flo. No flag, but Manninger in control that time.
It's not very often you say the Arsenal's back line has problems with aerial stuff, and I think apart from Tony Adams, there's no actual, there's very few players that I'd call total headers at the ball.
Four more minutes. Free kick which Keith Kerr will take. Plenty of big men to aim at. Havard Flo is there. Neil Emblem is there. Dean Richards is there. Now the referee has just had a word with the linesman on the far side, and there's a red card here. Something has happened off the ball. It's Emmanuel Petit. And Arsenal's dismal disciplinary record continues. 6 sent off in Arsene Wenger's first season. 6 more last season, and now Emmanuel Petit becomes the 7th Arsenal player to be sent off this season for the 3rd time in his Arsenal career. And clearly the official on the far side, Ray Gold, saw something which he has drawn the attention of referee Steve Dunn to, and Emmanuel Petit walks again. Grimondi and Vieira were sent off over the Christmas period, and now Petit follows them. We understand something he said to the linesman. Arsenal are going to make a change to try and shore things up and withdraw Nicolas Anelka and replace him with Gilles Grimondi. But it is an Achilles heel for Arsenal.
their continuing problems with authority. Free kick which Keith Kerr will take. Bound to be a lot of stoppage time. In towards Richards, dealt with by Upson. Grimondi's first touch shows too much of it to Simpson. Bergkamp. Adams, nicely done. For Wolverhampton Wanderers against a 10-man Arsenal now. Overmars. Oh, he saw Stowell just a few yards off his line.
But surely at this stage of the game, okay, surely at this stage of the game, you're looking for Overmars to carry the thing right into the final third, right into the top corner of the field, by time in there.
On by Flo, cleared by Dixon. Well, a strong header from Matthew Upson. Bergkamp getting involved in some jostling with Curl. Dixon away. Oh, Bergkamp getting involved now with Keith Curl. And there could be more trouble here. Curl reacted. And Grimondi has just thrown the ball. Somebody in the midst of the melee, what is going on here?
Well, this is sheer stupidity. It hasn't been the fieriest of games, to be fair. It's been a fairly placid affair for a cup tie, I think. Now, all of a sudden, petulance has crept in. I don't know what Petty did. We understand he said something. Whether he said it in French, English or what, we don't know, but that is stupid, that.
Now, Bergkamp is trying to appeal on behalf of Keith Curl. Cards are out again.
I mean, referees are criticised and maligned, but players do, you know, players do make it difficult for them, don't they?
Looks like yellow it is for Keith Curl.
Certainly appeared to be a blow struck.
And then Grimondi just hurled the ball at somebody. Tony Adams forward. Sedgley. This is Flo. Simpson. Flag against Keane is offside.
Yeah, spot on. Was offside.
You ready with Palmer? Mark Overmars gave Arsenal the lead after 10 minutes. Havard Flo equalised 10 minutes before the break. But a deflected goal hit by Dennis Bergkamp midway through the second half separates the two teams. And Ron, amidst all this, you've got to nominate a man of the match for us, please.
Yeah, well, I mean, there hadn't been too many outstanding performances. Let's see this through. We might be another man of the match yet.
Keane. Out as far as Simpson. Going across. Chance for Dean Richards. The flag's out. Offside.
Thought that was close. He was off with this good spot. But there's that fierce left-footed ball into the box again. So for me, it's got to be one of the, if you like, one of the workaday players. There he is. Ooh, it's close. He is off. I think
I'm
he's
not
just
sure.
There.
You know.
I know what you're saying. Ooh, that was close, but he has been worn back anyway. First of all, you know, I was going to have Remy Gard. He went off. Then, of course, Petty was a contender, and that's stupid, the thing he appears to have done. So he's worked up and down the pitch. He's done very well for him. He hasn't had a flary game, but he's worked very hard, Parlour.
Ray Parlour, man of the match in last season's cup final. Is Ron Atkinson's man of the match today. Stephen Hughes has come on for Arsenal. Wolverhampton Wanderers are going to make a change too, with David Connolly replacing Mark Atkins. We've had 2.5 minutes of stoppage time. There is David Connolly, rather belatedly.
Bergkamp, whose volley separates the two tees. Held on by Kerr. Arsenal have a throw in. Here is Stephen Hughes, who's been out of action through injury. I figured in the last couple of months. One last chance, maybe, for Wolves to rescue it. Keith Curl in towards Richards. A little flick off Flo. Sebsi trying to make something of it. Richards trying to make something of it. Oh, there's a handball there. Free kick to Wolves. Grimondi is the guilty man. We had a dramatic finish at Old Trafford earlier today. A dramatic finish you'll see a little later in our programme. Are we going to see a dramatic finish live on ITV now?
I tell you what I said earlier, Simpson's got a hell of a left foot. No matter who he's playing it, he's well capable in this position.
It's now or never for Wolverhampton Wanderers. Nearly 4 minutes of added time play. Number 11 is Osborne, number 3 Muscat. It's Paul Simpson. This would have come down for him. And after all sorts of ups and downs, Arsenal may well be home and dry.
It's strange because there wasn't a lot of heat in the game, was there? Sending off and then one or two players a bit lucky that they didn't get sent off in another fracas.
Beckham, well, he's getting involved with Curl again, and at this late stage, it doesn't make any sense.
I'll tell you what, Keith will be agitating him though. There's no danger about that.
Well, he's been sent off this season too. Here is Curl.
He'll be winding him right up.
That's it. The cup holders' grasp on the trophy remains thanks to Dennis Bergkamp's deflected volley midway through the second half. A tough tie for Arsenal here at Molineux. An element of fortune about the deciding goal. Bergkamp's volley striking first blow and then Curl. Arsenal hung on despite losing Emmanuel Petit, sent off in the closing moments. And go into the hat for the last 16 of the FA Cup. A draw that you will see live on ITV in a few moments' time. Final score here at Molineux this afternoon. Wolverhampton Wanderers 1, Arsenal 2.
It's finished 2-1 here at Molineux. The cup holders are in the draw for the fifth round. Gary Newbon is with Arsene Wenger.
A quick reaction to Petit sending off.
I don't know what happened, I think.
Apparently he just used strong language at the assistant referee.
Yes, but everybody in the dressing room said it's not right, it's not true. And I'm not happy at all with the referee today.
You're happy with the result, though, but what was wrong with the referee?
I don't want to speak about that, but I just think I'm not happy at all.
And the result?
Result, I think it was Wolves played well, had a very good first half and made it very difficult for us. It was a difficult game where we had to show our usual strength, our usual spirit and keep the pace high to make a difference in the second half. It was never easy and they were a good side today and deserve a lot of respect.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Not happy with the ref, he says, but we'll look at that in a moment. Lucky old Arsenal, he said, because of the way they got the winner, Kenny.
I don't think they were lucky. I think the turning point was when Flo hit the post after about 55 minutes. But this is the winning goal. It's just an obvious corner knocked in. Mark Atkins gets it cleared, but no well enough, unfortunately, just the edge of the box. It's a good hit. He's put his head on it. It comes off Flo's head, off Curl's thigh, and in the back of the net. It looks as if Anelka might be offside, but Jokes has come running out after it's been struck, so I think that goal might have been fortunate, but remember the corner came for a great save for the goalkeeper from Overmars. Yeah.
We can have a look at the Petit sending off. We think we can clear, we know that he's definitely waving his arms here, Gareth, isn't he?
Yeah, I mean, you can see here the play is going on and he's still having to go at the linesman.
Complaining about an offside, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, whether he said something, I mean, the linesman's done well to hear him from there, to be fair, but you know, only he knows what's happened, but it's a shame because that'll overshadow the game in the papers again tomorrow.
And, do you think they just deserved it?
Definitely, yeah. I mean, they were in control of the game. They had Wolves pinned back for a long period of the second half, and Wolves, after they hit the post, never really threatened.
OK. Well, more from the two men here in a few moments. But now a chance to reflect on how events unfolded earlier this